There was nothing left, just a little bit of oil, and so she had a situation looked hopeless. Life seemed empty. The fire that she had was gone, and she could no longer sustain a family. A widow with nothing. She was a widow with nothing.
Yeah.
That was her story. With a creditor approaching. In her modest brain, time of need, she stood all alone. No friends, no family. And they read the charges. You cannot pay a debt, your children will become a ransom, and they shall be taken. She cried, Lord, I have nothing left. I'm a widow with nothing. That was a testimony.
Amen.
He quickly came to her, see, he heard the cry of his soul. He led her to find Elijah, the prophet for the town. Go, thus said the Lord.
Amen.
God had already told me, your troubles will be gone. The story of your life will be different from now on. Bring every jar you can find, God will transform your life. The little love that you have will be multiplied.
Amen.
Even now, right now.
Yes, Lord.
Your children will never be slaves, and you will never be in debt anymore. God has chosen you, and in your home, He will wake a paradox.
Amen.
In your altar was empty, now I say with me, the widow who was weeping can rejoice and see. There was nothing today, you can have it all. Step up your faith and see God multiply your oil. By your fire spanish and a light each day. Just a lamb of his garment as it passed your way. All the soul you suffered in the hands of death, now sees the blessings of the Lord. Will be gone. The story of your life will be different from now on. Bring every jar you can find, God will transform your life. The little one that you have will be multiplied. Even now, right now, your children will never be slaves, and you will never be in debt anymore. God has chosen you. The widow who was sleeping can rejoice and sing. Where there was nothing today, you can have it all. Step up your faith and see God multiply your heart. Now your fire's burning, you shine on like this day. You touch the hem of his garment as it passed your way. All the soul you suffer at the hands of them, now sees the blessings of the Lord. Even now.
Without any waste of time, ritualing Lamudim, we are going straight to the Word of God.
Before we
read, let us pray. May God bless us.
Yehovah,
mighty God.
We are not going to be alone.
Amen.
If Allah really can, we are going to be Bjalo na Paulo yo ke le rapela ka bonolo le ka botho bja Kresete na yo ba rego ke mo ikokobetse re lebane ka difatlhego he ke fulere ya ba gona ke ga lefago.
Now I Paul myself beseech you by the meekness and gentleness of Christ, who in presence am base among you, but being absent am bold toward you.
Ke gopela gore ge ke tlo lebana le lena e seke ya ba ka khalefo le ka shishi ye ke bego ke re ke tla batla yona ke lwa le bao ba gore phara ba re ya ka tsela ya nama.
But I beseech you that I may not be bold when I am present with that confidence wherewith I think to be bold against some, which think of us as if we walked according to the flesh.
Gobane le ge re sepela re le nameng, ga re hlabane senama.
For though we walk in the flesh, we do not war after the flesh.
Marumo a hlabano ya rena ga se a nama, ke a matla ka Modimo a shwalanya dibo.
For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds.
Re swala nyamano le go iphagamisha gohle go shiteletsa go tsebo ya Modimo, re tswarara tlema menagano gore e kwe Kresete.
Casting down imaginations and every high thing that exalteth itself against the knowledge of God, and bringing into captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ.
Amen.
Homme ri tukishetse go sola go sekwe ka moka ge mo go lena go kwa e le go kwa moka.
And having in a readiness to revenge all disobedience when your obedience is fulfilled.
Amen.
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 Modimo a tlhono fa tse palo ya lentswe la
Modimo. God bless the reading of the word.
Dikatsiya madulo. Amen.
You may take your seats.
Ke bua ape ke le mmelisa mo lene le le matla la Kriste Jesu. Amen.
I once more greet you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Bela brother Masunda ba re le bale le ape verse 3.
Let us go back to the third verse. Yona ere gobane le ga re sepela re le nameng ga re hlabane senama.
Bana ba Modimo,
brethren,
he o joina leeto le la borapele.
When you join this Christian journey,
o tsa gore o joinile ntwa.
You must know that you have joined an army.
And o le sole la Christ.
You are a soldier of Christ.
Amen. That is why Christ a bolela mantswe a
Kabakalo. Christ speaks this word saying,
Amen.
Says if one wants to follow me,
ati gane yena,
he must first reject himself,
then arwalech fapano a sale morao,
carry the cross and follow
me. Ere kopani so bantu ba modimo,
as we are gathered like this,
remuntu e
we are in a war,
kare bophilo ba mokreste ka moka bona,
because the life of a Christian
kinkinto
is a warfare.
So verse 3,
in verse 3
Paul ubulela manje ari leri liba nama.
Paul says, though we are, well, though we walk in the flesh, we do not war after the flesh.
Our
war is not of flesh.
Amen.
For us to be able to overcome, the messenger of our time,
William Branham,
the one whom the whole world has refused or forsaken,
because
God works in his own way. He does not work with a popular someone. He uses a vessel that can be easily despised.
William Branham
came and taught us who is man, and taught us who is God.
So we are talking.
It is important that when you go to a warfare, you must know who you are.
Because
if you don't know yourself, then the enemy will play upon you.
So Paul
is warning us here, saying that the warfare that we're in, though we walk in the flesh, but we don't fight a fleshly war, but a spiritual one. You remember some time back when we started this matter,
putting all the whole armor of God.
We talked about
and then Paul
Olus.
William Branham,
Brother Branham speaks these words.
I preach what Paul preached.
He rather fell as Paul is as a
religious.
Paul also warned us,
say
all the armors of a Christian,
Galatians chapter 5,
Galatians
22.
You can read them, but we read them some time back. He spoke of faith,
lirato,
love,
patience,
and
then meekness,
wigobo,
and gentleness.
So
the armor of God.
All these are the armor of God.
You remember some time when
we started this matter?
We spoke
on faith. That a Christian,
a pilgrim born,
does not live by sight.
Amen.
He lives by
faith.
We spoke on another subject of the armors that can help us to overcome the evil one.
Amen.
Is prayer. Prayer, brethren, is very important.
Jesus
Christ taught us how to pray.
So
he also showed us that in prayer, there's power of overcoming the evil one. Doesn't matter what kind of a weapon he may bring forth. But what is most important
before you rappel
is that before we pray, we must watch ourselves as to who we are. You see, Paul, he speaks specific things. He says, examine yourself first and watch if you have faith and see if Jesus Christ is in you.
So
when God says we must pray without ceasing,
before you tap in,
we must examine ourselves that before we go to prayer, that we are standing good with God.
Because
the servant of God,
body, spirit, and soul.
Amen.
So,
even you, there's a way that God wants you to approach Him by. When they say, let us pray, or time of prayer arrives at you, you must watch if you are standing well with God.
Amen.
Before you go to prayer, Jesus Christ has given us a way for us to arrive in the presence of God.
Amen.
Let us first accept that we are sinners. If we can accept that we are sinners, our God is good. When we confess our sins, and when we
when we pray, He forgives us. If you see God not forgiving us, it is because we do not confess. I used to speak with my brethren. There's a certain saying in Venda, that saying hinders us from coming to God. You are hiding a sin. Until they say, I will die with this one. This is the Venda language. This one, it delays you to arrive in the presence of God. There's a power when someone confesses the sins before God. When you pray, God forgives all your sins. Prayer, brethren, is one of the asanas that God has given unto us that you will be able to overcome by. Jesus Christ, He wants us to walk on His footpath because He is our example. There are no challenges that Jesus Christ faced that will be received by you and me.
So, the disciples of Jesus Christ,
if you want to be true disciples of Christ, we must know that we have joined an army here.
As long as we have joined the soul,
and when we have joined an army, we need to carry our cross
and then
and follow Christ.
So what are the answer of our doing?
On the matter of prayer, brethren,
Jesus Christ routine.
Jesus Christ has taught us that when we pray,
Jesus Christ,
if you look carefully at that prayer, just taught us
in Alimata,
it has got power in
because
it.
Of Bible
Because the Bible says, even though we don't know how to pray, the Holy Ghost will teach us how to pray.
So Jesus Christ
taught us that when we pray, we need to praise our God, our Father who art in heaven. We give Him His glory. We don't just start by arriving.
He is my Father.
Let's say I don't just arrive,
Father,
give me money. We said must say God, we must give Him first His glory. After giving Him His glory, when we arrive deep into prayer, we ask Him of all what our needs. As we continue,
she can really receive.
Before we receive those,
ready out, ready level.
Give thanks. And knowing that by faith we've already received them, then we close our prayer.
Before
But before it comes to the issue of asking from God, there around Matthew 6, where He taught us this great prayer, He talks about forgetting or for forgiveness. God has got a way that He wants to forgive us. He doesn't just forgive us automatically. You must first acknowledge your faults
and then repent.
Then God will forgive you.
So
there are people
who
in our time, because
we are Christian,
we think that if I have wronged a brother, he must just forgive me automatically. It does not work like that.
I must acknowledge my wrongs.
Approach him and ask for forgiveness. You know there are things that are hindering us.
And then Satan affects our disarmor.
Until the devil disarms us. So that we don't see the purpose of prayer, the importance.
Who is Brother Maluka?
Is it Mang Maluka? That I should approach him and say I'm sorry to him. You see pride. It made a king.
And he could be for 52 years.
That was famous for 52 years. When he died in sin. And went straight to hell. Why?
A pride.
When the priest approached him, rebuked him. that this thing is not supposed to be done by you. He took
experience.
In Christianity, we don't use experience. He said, who art thou? I've been doing things and they were coming to pass. I want to find that he was despising the children of God. Refusing to be rebuked by the children of God. God hit him with leprosy. When you have time, you can go and read the story.
Second Chronicle.
Chapter
25 or 26.
There was a man who was a king
at the age of 16 years. And the Bible
says whatever he touched, because he was led by God. God was blessing him. Until the point where he lost the glory of God. Then only pride entered him.
Yes, William Branham.
When is Branham?
Like pride.
When he speaks of homosexual, he says one of the weapons that the devil utilizes
disarm.
For Muhammad, you must go to prayer. You must first make sure that you have forgiven each other with your brother. How are you going to look at each other when pride is in? I will not go to the brother and ask for forgiveness. He will take me lightly. That is the devil disarming you.
So
the word of God shows to us that to confess our sins, there is power in there. When you go to prayer, God will hear thine prayers.
Amen.
That answers thine request. So as
Christian,
we must make sure that the time of praying or practicing church and eating has come to an end. This is the time to fulfill the scriptures. Let us check what the scripture says about this matter of forgiveness. Let it not be an automatic thing.
As long as
only that because I gave him a lollipop, he has forgiven me. No, that's not like that. You know, Bible says, all of us, we are born in sin.
And
we must accept that we are born in sin. When you read from Luke 17, verse 5, the apostle acknowledges, he says, me a sinner. When you accept that you are wrong, you don't lose anything. Instead, you gain power for you to be able to go forward. God,
the whole armor of God,
we must walk by faith. Now let us look a little bit at the one
for short, two times.
I think we spoke on it about twice back there.
So
God wants us that when you go into prayer,
we must confess our sin and repent. And ask for forgiveness.
God is ready to forgive us.
First John chapter 1. Verse
19.
First
John chapter?
Chapter 1.
Verse 19. You see, when we confess our sins, when we confess our sins, the question is that do we ever sometime arrive at the situation where we have to first confess our sins? Because the Bible says when we first confess our sins, read it, brother, all of it.
Mm-hmm.
Our God is good.
And
all things are possible through Him. When we see things not coming to pass, it's not that before Him they are impossible. It's our ways. That makes things not to be possible. Before God, they are possible. The scripture that we just read, it says, if we confess our sins, God is gracious and He forgives all of our sins.
Amen.
Our God is good. Ours is just to acknowledge that we are sinners. If we can acknowledge that we are sinners,
what's for recognize that we are not yourself
for tomorrow. Don't try to cover that sin. Confess it. So that it can be in the public. Sometime back the pastor was giving us an example with a certain brother.
Our elder
Renafa.
Brother Lugod.
One should body.
Are Sali at least at your zone
that once took a ganja zol.
Are she's processing some sampala.
He said, brethren, this thing is troubling me. I believe that
Naya channel of my brother Lihodi.
It's not supposed to be only brother Lihodi.
There
are things that are difficult for us.
Not confess.
That we need to come and confess.
And here can confess.
If we can confess them
and then
and pray unto God. We would have paved a way for ourselves to overcome the devil. There are things that the devil that he uses so that people don't arrive at the matter of forgive or of repentance.
No repentance,
confessing and also asking for forgiveness.
We are an arrogant spirit. Arrogant spirit.
Moya o ipona ogare wena kwena.
Satan wa disarm.
Diabolo is disarming you.
So let's even into everyone.
You must know that the warfare that we're in.
Mumula yeti mwa the greatest battle ever fought.
More the message mundwe hulu kile ngalwana.
Mutanga mudimu.
The servant of God, it says, when the spirit fights a battle, being the spirit of God,
this arrogance.
It fights also against the spirit of arrogance.
So,
because the brother has hijacked me,
no chance of
he was supposed to be the one preaching. I'll say, let's look at this matter of
William Branham.
Brother Branham speaks the truth.
Yeah.
The Holy Ghost
is an arrogant spirit.
Fights against an arrogant spirit.
And this arrogant spirit
is disturbing you to come to the presence of God.
And
one of the things that the spirit is fighting against
is ascension. And if we don't overcome this ascension,
if you are able to overcome my ikwelo,
as long as you misalim tila mudim,
by using the word of God,
amen.
You are opening or paving a way to God. But the Bible says the other thing is,
moyo mudimu ulwali feeling.
The spirit of God is fighting against feelings. My ikuto. Mama, I don't feel like going to the service.
Mugrest da pile ka feeling.
A Christian living by feelings. The brother says, this is the devil. Bring unto you feelings.
So
he says, if you have the spirit of God,
for chance of
you must overcome that.
And then
distance.
Pay attention more to.
Do not pay attention on them. The Bible, where we read in the first scripture, we bind our thoughts that we can only hear Christ.
Because Christ,
he is not our husband. He is not money.
Like through God, we feel we pillow put some money clear.
You know, God gave us that our life should go clear.
When we pillow put some money clear.
If you see that life is not going clear,
but to say our God chimney a day,
man fell back in the Garden of Eden.
Unyaga di sila taha.
He is trying to find his own ways. Does not need God's way.
So we can come to God. We are not.
The Son of God speaks and says,
"Are temen mina hanoyari."
He said, "Let us bind all our." Thoughts. So that when we hear
request Christ,
we should only hear Christ
as our husband.
Joanna, come on, now,
because of Rina,
because us,
as long as
we believe that as long as we are born again, by this message,
we are the bride of Jesus Christ. So the bride of Jesus Christ. The bridegroom.
Only he has the husband.
That's
why the word of God speaks
from natural side.
Says woman. How can unto a man at all times?
First Peter chapter 3.
When read it from the book of First Peter chapter 3.
So here Paul is a mystery.
When Paul brings to Tabaya Topa, because last week. The brothers were preaching here.
They reveal things
wrong
to us.
When it comes to us,
Christ is our husband.
Christ, we must be the ones who are hearing him only in everything. Because as our husband,
he is our chief captain.
Yeah, captain and whole.
You have no failure.
He was able to overcome. What made him to overcome? It's because he knew who he was.
Okay.
The Son of God says, when the devil attacks Christ,
three times wide attack. It is written.
Christ only overcame by it is written.
So Colossians chapter 3.
When you read the Bible from book of Colossians,
the Bible
says this way. Let it dwell in us. And then go forth. So that by this way you should be able to overcome. When the devil or the evil one attacks,
it's written. It is written.
You won't be able to say who might watch me when you are not feasting upon the way.
That is
why the word of God,
the whole armor of God,
that God has given, that by it we should be able to overcome.
So, First John chapter 1.
We have read the Bible from the book of First John chapter 1,
verse 9.
It says, our God is righteous. First, we need to confess our sins. You see, we feel I can be involved in sin and hide myself and hiding from you people. I do not hide from the camera of God. God will come and reveal it, that sin,
and then at Allah's word,
and you'll be able to see it. It is important that if you know that something that there's something that is difficult to you, speak it or confess it. God will forgive you.
You
see, for our prayer to reach God, what must we have?
We must confess, repent, and forgiveness.
One issue won't be able to forgive me
automatically.
God, fail. Go to him. We did wrong unto another. The Bible says, you must sit down and talk. This is what the scripture says. If we are unable to reach a consensus, be the truth, I must take the brother. We go there being free. I used to ask myself that people of our time, being able to read. People of old were not able to read the Bible. I'm not such an old person. I know that our parents were not reading the Bible. If this one had wronged that other family, sometimes when they see that together they could not reach an agreement, they seek the third person to go in there and say, I was sent by the second sort of family. That is, they saying, I came here and made an error. We are asking for forgiveness. I don't know whether you know this song
or it.
But I want this matter to remain my brother. We need a mediator.
One
will come and mediate our matter so that our matter can come to an end. This thing the people of old were doing, not being able to read the Bible. Today we are some
example.
that if you have wronged your brother, what is it that you need to do?
But because Satan got to laugh at the pride.
Because the devil has thrown in with
whom you are going to so evil curse.
The devil of God or
evil curse, pride.
Is the one that makes us not to be able to ask forgiveness from one another. If we are, we believe that we are children of God,
we must confess our sin.
Responsibly,
and repent.
Resogulu.
And ask for forgiveness. Genesis chapter 50.
Let's go to the book of Genesis chapter 50.
Or masume amahlanu.
Verse 17. The 17th verse that we have an example where we can take from. From verse 17, let's read only the 17th verse. Lebuleleng le Josepha ke yona ke. Lebuleleng le Josepha le re. Hle anke o lebalele bana ba tata go bogopo yola le sebe sa bona. Hobane ba go dirile tsempe go mme jalo a gore le ba lelehle a gore le ba lelehle rena ba hlanka ba modimo wa tatago re ba bolella mantu a Josepha a nampile Allah
la bona re bo hira life.
Can you see what's happening here?
Le kai ba lape bro,
you can read again brother.
Le sa kitimi
slowly le boleleng le Jehova le Josepha le re se anke o lebalele bana ba tata go bogopo yola le sebe sa bona
ke Josepha mo.
This is Joseph here
le bo buru wa gae
and his brothers
ba nama
physical ones
ba carnal ones ka ringa no re ba ba madi
or the blood ones
ka re ya tlo Josepha ba tswa sa le ba modira mo bo bi ke bo buru wa ba 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 madi.
We know that the people who did wrong unto Joseph are his own blood brothers.
Una statement the most ya tlele.
There's a statement that comes up here.
Josepha
that Joseph
anke li bulele li yena a re ba lele bana ba.
Please talk to him that he forgives his brethren
and tlela pele li ba le happy ona se bending it.
Continue and read brother. Hle anke o lebalele bana ba tata go bogopo yola le sebe sa bona gobane ba go dirile tsempe gomme bjalo a ko re lebalele hle
ke bona moe le ka utlwa pele.
If you can listen here, is them now
bjalo ba ya ko yena Joseph.
They are approaching him Joseph
anke o re lebalele
say unto him please forgive us
se ba go dirile tsona
what they have done to him
ba khupela o lebalele.
They are asking to be forgiven.
Amen.
Ifeleletseng bro.
Amen.
Gomme bjalo a ko re lebalele hle rena ba sanka ba modimo wa tatago. Read it in his brother.
So shall you say unto Joseph, forgive, I pray thee now, the trespass of thy brethren and their sin, for they did unto thee evil. And now we pray thee, forgive the trespass of the servants of the God of thy father. And Joseph wept when they spake unto him.
La bona Joseph fa go di right.
You see what Joseph does?
E se gore ke modimo ndi.
Not that is God.
O bona ka tsela e batlang go tlhopela tshwarelo ka yona.
He realized the manner in which they come and ask for forgiveness.
And ya mo hlaba ka pilu.
And it pricked him in his heart.
Re bona sa go tshwaretse.
To show that he has forgiven them.
Walla.
He cries.
Because ba ile bona.
Because they went to him.
Ba yo khupela o tshwarelwa.
And asked for forgiveness.
Ke Joseph.
Amen. By Joseph.
So bana ba modimo.
Brethren.
Taba ya hana confess our wrongs.
This matter of refusing to confess our wrongs.
And re hana hore repent.
And not wanting to repent.
E shitisa dithapelo tsa rena ho ya modimo.
Blocks our prayers to reach God.
Modimo nyaka re ni tamo yena.
God wants that when we cry to him.
As Christian.
Jwalo ka ba Christ.
Re rwa le ditlamo ka moka.
We should carry all our armors.
And engwe ya ditlamo tse ke thapela.
One of them is prayer.
And thapela tshwantse e be le tumelo.
This prayer must be accompanied by faith.
Tumelo ka mara tshwantse e be le khopi le o lebalela.
When it has faith in it, it must have forgiveness as well.
Ke ona modimo a tlo khono ya raba.
That's where God will be able to answer it.
So he modimo a araba I ri nyaka ra araba ditlamo tsa rena.
If one God to answer our prayers,
re tshwantse re tsamaye ya ka tsela e modimo a re fileng.
We must go according to the path that he gave us.
Confess
ipolele dibe,
repent
sokoloha
and forgiveness
o lebalele
ba re baleng lentswe la modimo.
Let's read the word of God.
Second Chronicle
ba koronika ba bobedi
chapter 7 Verse 14.
Ba kone ka hore ene temanya go shupa temananya le sumenne.
Yeah, verse 14.
Se chaba saka. Se se bitwa go ka ina laka. Ge se ka ikokobetsa.
La bona bana ba modimo.
You see brother,
go na le taba e modimo a re fang yona e re tshwantsere go rapela.
The something that God gives us here when we're supposed to.
Here we tell this chama sa modimo.
If we are called God's nation,
re tshwantsere go kokobetsa.
We must humble ourselves.
Amen. And after we kokobetsa ona le something le ka tswela pele ba.
Let's continue.
Se chama saka se se bitwa go ka le ina laka. Ge se ka ikokobetsa. We don't just start by praying.
Yeah.
We must first humble ourselves.
And then,
then we pray.
Mm.
Continue, brother.
Amen.
Jessica Kokovecha. Sarapela. Sanyaka Sufatosaka. Salatanitila Jimbi Chasona.
You
must know that this is the nation of God. They humble themselves. Pray. Seeking God's faith.
And then face.
And forget of our evil ways. And seek God's face.
Read the
rest of it, brother.
Salasa ditsela tse mpe tsa sona hona ke tlo ba akwa ke le go di mo
amen
ka ba lebalela sebe ka fodisha naga ya bona
modimo o fihlile dilo in simplicity.
God has hidden things in simplicity
and you do like in simplicity
and also revealed them in simplicity.
The message says
mulaitsa o
the revealed things
dilo tse di tlutlwego
belong to us
itsa rena.
So yeah, simple.
God gives us things in simplicity. We must just humble ourselves. Pray. Seek God's face. And forsake our old ways. God says, I will hearken unto thine prayers.
Amen.
Being in heaven.
And then
and forgive us our sins. Then heal our land.
As Christian.
You see, like a Christian.
Weapon.
You are carrying a weapon here. That even the Ramaphosa cannot even witness. If we can utilize it correctly. This sickness that is upon the whole world, where in the a soldier in Christ,
as it
won't stand before a Christian soldier. As long as we come the right way, the Bible says we should humble ourselves
and then repent
and pray, seek God's face. You heard the brother when he was praying here?
Are not option B.
Saying we don't have plan B. All what we want is God's face. Jacob also said, I will never forsake thee until you bless me. We must fight, seek God. Pray unto him until we bind him with his own promise. Because himself God,
he is sure by himself.
And said, I will never forsake thee.
Amen.
I will be with you to the end of time.
Amen.
Ours, brethren, is to come through the right way. If we just go back to the verse that you just read, he speaks of humility
and then rapela
and pray, seek God's face,
and then
God being in heaven will hearken unto our prayers.
He
will forgive us our sins and also heal our land. You see what the brother writes.
Humble ourselves.
In English, it speaks of humility. In other words, it simply means we forget about pride. Because we almost is not leading us anywhere. If you're a child of God who reads the word of God, you will see that some of the things that hinders God from answering his children's prayers
over self-centered.
Na.
Jesus Christ, are deny yourself.
Jesus Christ says, Ikhane, carry my cross, your cross, and follow me.
So the
word of God, brother, shows us that God
in simplicity
has hidden things in simplicity and also revealed them in simplicity. After revealing them, they are ours. He said, healing is ours.
So, forgiveness,
only when we believe God's way.
Because Satan says,
because what the devil utilizes, for him to be able to disarm you,
he attacks
you the word of God. But if you can take God at his
word, Corinthians.
We read in the book of 2 Corinthians,
chapter 10.
The man who was so mad,
was cast down reasoning. Because of the cause of our reasoning.
We won't please God through reasoning. We can all please God by faith.
And then we're aware with reasoning.
And believe only the word of God. All things are possible.
So,
brethren, that is why the word of God, when it speaks with you and me,
fear not, you little flock.
Listen, we have seen
the
power that is given unto us. When Brahman explains this,
he says
this power is above the atomic bomb that can be done by
Russians. And this weapon, is to just to put it all.
It's in the word of God. God has placed all the promise in his way. When you need healing, is here.
And when, as long as you confess,
as long as you apologize,
and then repent. I get discouraged about the prayer request.
I'm not discouraged that people should not bring prayer requests here. You must bring that request being right.
And then before,
so that God can answer you way before they even pray for that request.
So here you
can trust in God. Maybe I can bother you. I must stop bothering
him.
If I can trust in God.
Now and then,
time and again,
Rumasund,
wanna show masund?
Properly say,
hey, pray with me.
Hey, say.
This and that. I must add, take God at his word and trust him and say, God, you spoke and said all these things
belong to us. As
your children,
the promise,
the temptation that are in here, God has placed them for us. Only when we come to the right way, that's why the word of God speaks this way. We are first, all of us here. We must be born again and move away from our flesh.
Because
Paul also speaks. He says, well, though we walk according to the flesh, but our warfare is not of flesh. We are fighting a spiritual warfare. And the spiritual warfare, the weapon that God has given unto us, I don't know whether you sometimes meditate upon the ways that are put here.
The message that
was preached.
Mudim,
God,
He
gave us Himself so that we can be able to overcome. Whatever the devil may try to throw in, we are overcoming. Because God has given us Himself. By giving us Himself is to take Him at His way. Because this way, it's not just letters, it is alive. What can make this to be alive is when you allow God to plant it in you,
and they have one another to guide them,
that it be the one to guide you at all times. When you come across challenges,
When
the devil comes and tempts you,
you will
just speak and say, it is written that man does not survive by bread alone, but by all the weather come not proceeded out of the word of God, out of the mouth of God. You know, brethren, the way this world is so lost,
including
including religions. Forgive me, brother, they all sometimes say we are judgmental. But this is what the word of God is.
Judges.
You see how lost the world is.
Including
including religions.
Amen.
You know, there are certain services. You heard the pastor said sometime back here,
young people
talking about baswa.
Only some other assemblies.
There are
putojini gospel ya Paul.
They said we should no longer preach Paul's gospel
because Paul
They are saying the gospel of Paul has come to an end. What I want to bring to you, brethren,
Paul,
Paulus, the one who
laid
the foundation. He said even if he comes back and preach another gospel contrary to this one, he said, let me be accursed. For me to speak this statement is because there are certain religions. They sometimes say, they say if you don't put on miniskirts, you won't get married. Let me tell you, the marriage that you will get through putting on a miniskirt
is not the proper marriage.
You must understand the word of God. There is lerato
and lust.
Marriage.
Ephesians chapter 5.
When we read from the book of Ephesians, our son,
Paul is a mystery. So our precious brother last week, this mystery.
One issue make our faith spoke about Topa here.
It's revealed. And because it's already revealed, belong to us.
If you need marriage, there is a way that God has placed that you should seek it by. You search for marriage through the word. Because says is the mystery of God. But God has revealed it. Revealed it to his own. When you need marriage,
consult Mudim.
Consult God. Don't change your attitude of being a Christian. This one goes up and down. They say, oh, you can't be like this. There are some creams out there. They make you to be more visible.
Within
God,
the inner beauty
looks for outside. It brings forth fruits
as moya.
The spiritual fruits
as moya.
Spiritual fruits. You must know that the
Son
of God is saying,
as long as
you live in
Christ.
He says, only if you're a Christian and live by things that are not seen, you are live by the correct things. But if you live by things that can be seen, they are temporal. They are temporal.
So young brothers, young sisters,
the matter of worship is not for elderly ones. You must also pray so that even when your parents are praying on your behalf, they must find that you are also protecting yourself through prayer, so that you should know when they say the things of this world are impossible, before God they are possible. In the message, you don't put a law for people. If you want to see marriage being blessed by God. Speak it by the word of God. When the Son of God speaks, says,
a young brother, if
he wants to get married,
a sister,
look at the sister. They must not look at the brother must pray first, and then God will reveal to him.
That is a right sister.
When it continues, says,
are you young sisters?
If you look that this brother has got lots of money in his bank account, those are worldly things. The word of God says, the heavens and the earth will pass, but the word of God will spare to eternity. We must live by the things unseen.
Amen.
And believe that God is there.
And
those who trust upon Him,
Amen.
He blesses them.
Amen.
Take up your trust and put it to God.
And then whatever
you need, pray unto God. That's why God speaks the words. Whatever we do can be through our minds,
or
by our hands,
or
we want to speak. Let us speak that by the word of God, by the name of God. The word of God will never fail you, never,
because
God does not fail. When God does things, He knew that there will be people who will take it according to His way. It is important that children of God, when we hear the word of God, it should not end in this class. Let Christianity be a lifestyle. When they say brothers, we should not do funny hairstyles. Let it be a lifestyle. Let me not come here with a hairstyle. During the week, I just do as I wish. I don't live for the brothers. You live for yourself. This is Zulu City. Whatever thou doest, you do for yourself. If you trust unto God, all the promise that God is going to bless you with, they are yours.
So that's why we
say, brethren, we did not come to a rosy bed. We came to a warfare here. For us to overcome this warfare, God has given us Himself. In his and also give us things that are unseen. A Christian should live by faith.
And then arapele.
And pray.
And then arapele.
When you pray, you must make sure that you have repented from your sins. And then God will forgive you. Our problem is, brethren, we are trying to talk
about it.
Even when you realize that you have wronged, you don't want to accept your sin.
Try to justify.
Will not help us anyhow.
So
brethren, what can help us is to take God at His
word.
Let's go to the book of Acts, chapter 8,
verse 22.
I don't know if they are at home there. Is there anybody who still does not believe that Madam Branham is our messenger? If you take him and compare him with the Bible, he only preached the Bible and also revealed which were mysteries.
Amen. Galatians chapter 5.
Don't close Galatians
chapter 5.
Bahalato
Sanu. Verse 19.
We can start it there by verse 19. And go down and read. Oh, let us know. I'm not saying we should read it. It is read by everyone. And if we believe the way it is, we never knew that.
Verse 22.
The man who spoke the
is the whole armor of God.
He will lack any shame or come or catch a grace.
Only the good things.
Lord, you do not judge him.
William Branham.
Amen.
O tsetsa wa nako.
And
o
di bale.
You must ponder them.
O tlokola re kidilo tse di sa boneng.
You will see that these are things unseen.
Ora re ntare o ka ntsha mo se wa letsi wa le rato wena bro.
If I can ask you brother, explain to me what is love?
Ke la thalama.
Hey. What color is love? It's unseen.
Yeah.
It's not sa boneng, but it's the greatest weapon. E o tsha ke se hlamo e kholoka go.
E mo Christ a ka fenya ka yona.
Then the Christian can overcome by. Ke
re ntsha mo se tsere tumelo ke
bia. If I can ask you to explain to me what kind of a thing is faith?
It's unseen thing.
Kim draws the worry,
but it's the greatest weapon.
E o tsha ke hlamo e kholoka go.
Christ a ka fenya ka yona.
That the Christian can overcome by.
And he a tlhalosa mothlanga modimo.
When he explained the seven of God.
A re nka ofa di million.
He said, I can offer you millions. I'm giving you millions, I'm sending you. Go and purchase for me faith. Will you be able to come back with this? No. That's it.
I wanna ask.
It is unseen.
Greatest weapon.
So Bible says faith cometh by hearing the word of God.
Amen.
Let us read Acts, what was the Swai?
22.
Temana Yamasume, Pedipe. Alright. You're not here.
Is it?
It's all Olahle bobe byo bya gago.
Formula ya o tla modimo.
The formula to approach God
ko ithola pele
is to repent.
Ke ba le bororo.
Oh, friend brother.
Repent therefore of this thy wickedness.
Yeah.
Le ka ifeleletsa bo.
It's all Olahle bobe byo bya gago. O rapele modimo. Gore mohlomo ngwe o lebalelwe bo manager byo. The formula to come to God is to repent before you go into prayer. That's what the Bible says. You can read it rather and finish it in English.
Repent therefore of this thy wickedness and pray God if perhaps the thought of thine heart may be forgiven thee.
Hallelujah. Remember, we want an armor that God can forgive us by.
Formula ya bona ke yona.
Here's the formula.
Ya buruma masonda. Ya buruma masonda ron rutile spell
because Bra Mosina has taught me spell.
Ke itshole.
It says repent.
Amen.
He ke ano itshola.
If I'm unable to repent,
ke mona tshwantse a itshole a itsholele.
Who will repent on my behalf?
Nna
myself.
Bibele iri itshole.
It says I should repent myself
before ke ya modimo.
Bibele ke ya before God.
Ba le la mafelelo re tlwe mo yona.
Read for the last time.
Ke bro ka ima la mafelelo re tlwe mo yona.
Yona iri itshole. O lahle bo bi byo.
A ke no fetsa o itshola.
After repenting,
a o sa boela gape mo.
You don't go back to that evil way
wa bula.
You throw it away.
Ke o fumo la ka ba tametsa modimo.
Amen.
The message brings us closer to God.
Le ka ifeleletse.
Itshole o lahlebo bo byo bya gago. O rapele modimo. Gore mohlomongwe o lebalelwe bo manager byo ka pelo ya gago. You don't just start by praying.
Bible
says so.
Itshole
repent. First,
for last,
and forget, leave behind your evil ways, and pray. That is where you can be forgiven of your evil things. That's how we come to God.
So
you see, we are hindering our way of coming to God
because of the arrogant spirit. This message,
if we can read this message,
the greatest battle ever fought.
The Son of God says the Spirit of God is fighting against this arrogant spirit.
Amen.
Ya mudimo
God
o re file mo yena
He gave us Himself. So that at the end, that we can be overcomers. Because He was able to overcome all things at the cross.
So
it is important that as children of God, we should take God at His
weight.
When God speaks in the book of Malachi
4,
when saying the great and dreadful day is coming,
and then before
that day cometh, I will send my messenger so that you should turn the heart of the children to their fathers.
And then
and turn those of the fathers to their children. Because if you won't do like that, he will smite the whole world.
And
then surely he thought that I must bring the messenger.
So the
messenger came.
But oh brother,
and said, oh one issue,
one day,
that you know,
when the ignorance, superstition, doubt, frustration, and fear,
no wafer.
Had God's people back into the corner.
You see the things that back people at the corner.
Ignorance.
Paragraph 389A. One issue. These are the things that took the children of God and placed them in a corner.
It's all nothing.
These are the things. You see, we came to the service. The servant of God is holding a service here.
Forever message you are the revelation of the Son of Man.
Preaching Tabaya.
And that is a powerful message.
Amen. If you don't see him today being here, even
making
a photo of us all,
that message.
When people visit that message at YouTube, the same people of social group, they do feel. But let me tell you what social groups do have.
Powerful.
Yeah. This is a powerful message.
But
people are looking for that.
That's why we wanted today. Two Sundays are not Murutu
That's why sometimes you don't have our pastor here.
Because Renari ignorance. When we are
having a phone, we are
busy
with our own phones. Others out there
when
you're having a phone.
Channel ya social movement Bible believers.
They visit our channel.
Message what the revelation of
they find the servant of God there preaching the message. But we need to request this man to come and preach this message here.
So remember to social movie.
We the social movements,
if not specific,
give it to me.
Paragraph 389 more messaging what the best better ever for.
Paragraph in here, bullet in here, Yamalaja.
Ignorance.
We are ignorant.
Superstition.
Metwai.
Dimorim.
It's us. Don't come to my house and ask for salt at night. I will tell you, by law, a salt is not supposed to go out of the house at night. Those are metwai.
Doubt. frustration,
okamaka,
and fear. No way,
they
backed the children of God in a corner.
Sure.
And then,
and you
know, those are who are good in explaining things.
Yes. If
they tell about fear,
but it's false evidence. Appearing real.
And indeed, the devil push you at the corner there.
So this fear,
what are we for now?
William Branham.
What is Branham?
He
says it's one of the things that the devil used to disarm you.
But
if we take God at his word,
fear not.
Amen. You little flock.
Amen.
God has promised to be with us to the end of time.
Amen.
You see the thing that are pushing us at a corner?
Ignorance,
mm-hmm.
Superstition,
metroid,
doubt, frustration, and fear.
All of them, these things, they've put somebody where? If one can recognize that you are a child of God,
and then
and come out of these things,
don't pay any attention to just to Satan.
The Son of God, or also God, we are shady.
So
he are
going to come to Mudim are God's army.
When he speaks, says Mashallah Mudim. It sounds much better when the brothers
read it. As God's army refuel yan paleleng ona mo bro. Yiri God's army
madira a modimo.
Close up your mind.
So lelang mehopolo ya lena.
Don't stop for a minute.
Listen ke la ema motsotso
to think of anything the devil has got to offer you.
Ho hopola ka eng ka ba eng dia hola ka go fa go yona.
Your senses. But remember, God's word can never fail.
Amen.
So for a commission, God's army. Close up your mind.
So
don't stop for a minute. To think of anything the devil has got to offer. But remember, God's words can never fail.
Let us stay by the word of God at all times.
And then come out of this camp.
The pastor taught us of the message getting beyond the camp.
Ignorance.
Let us come out of the camp.
Superstition.
Ignorance.
Doubt.
Frustration.
And stand as a soldier of God.
Amen. And not be afraid of anything. When we abide by God's ways. When the devil attacks
Jesus Christ three times.
The same way he attacked Christ thrice.
We not to know who are
you. You will stand up and say it is written.
Amen.
When he comes and attack to the youth. They will entice you with certain things. You must know that the things that are seen are temporal. The unseen one are eternal.
Amen.
Bro, why you think you feel like discouraged about bro transporting? But the brother knows that sometimes discourage the brothers where we bought our transport. And we say to them, you see this humanizer brothers. You know, sometimes we get into the same transport with
school
kids. The brother will entice a school kid by taking out a purse, a wallet. Wants to buy sweets. For a poor girl. But you can see that the wallet is full.
So that's why we should not live by
we should not live by things that are seen.
They
are temporal.
The
word of God.
It won't fail you.
Amen.
The Son of God says, it
stands forever.
So
you know what Satan he used to disarm you.
What on the
he made you to
and be, to disbelieve God's word.
O dira gore o se ke wa dumela lentšu la Modimo.
Mara wena as Christian,
e upya wena bela ka mo Kriste.
Dumela lentšu la Modimo.
Amen.
Believe the word of God
and then o tse Modimo le jing la gae.
Take God at his word
and then mafelo go tloba mo feng.
Finally you will be overcome.
O se ka be wa ema le metsotsonyana.
Don't stop for a moment.
Gore o fe Satan sebaka.
That you give the devil an opportunity.
Because la tiba go tshimo ya Eden we di right in.
Because we know what happened in the garden of Eden.
E ba o file nyana Satan metsotsonyana.
Eve gave the devil little time
and after that all fulfill the scripture say that everything got so
then she failed to fulfill the open scripture
cast down reason
lahle na kwa thoko ho nganisha
thoma ho reason le satha
a thoma started arguing with the devil
what tsiba re modimo go tsaba re le ka just tharisina
you see when God said when if eat that tree
le tlo tlhalifa la tla tshwana le
yena you will be wise like him
ya batlo ya re efa ba no ba mutantse
that was where Eve was caught
so re fiwe tsila ba no ba modimo
were given a way brethren
ya go tla ho modimo
of coming to God
and dilo ka moka
all things
la tsiba re le fasile
you know this what I
ba fela ba dula fasi
they sometimes sit down
ba re rila constitution ya fasi
and they say we are drafting a world constitution
let's go ba western now
you know that they are wasting their times
ba tlo change the constitution ba di change ba di change
they will change constitution one after another
because it is reason
they will do nothing
the creator of heaven and earth
o hlodi ba mahodi mo le mafasi
permanent constitution
yena o na le molao theo wa go ya wi
and this constitution
o na molao theo o
e batho ba ka thopa ka itsiya
if people can take it
ba se shumise mo kerekeng
and not use it in church
ka mo aratela o kereka
because we will come here to
what is fini e
church members this constitution
e thoma ko lape
starts at home
before it will fit mo kerekeng
before it reaches
ke go botsa le church le parliament ya bona e tlo
I'm telling you their parliament will even fall.
Let's be rena as Christian.
You know as Christians,
ke rena tshwantse re bonse le fast.
We should show the word
of Christ constitution ya maliba.
That we are living the right constitution.
Fela here rena ka confess our wrongs.
He fela ka ipolla dipitsa rena
and ra repent.
Ra sokoloha
ra rapela Modimo
and ra pray to God.
Ra kopela ra tshwarele dipitsa rena
and ask him to forgive us.
And after go re tshwarela
after forgiving us.
Eh ni challenge and fast le ikopa le kuba kongwa ka
whatever the challenge that the world is facing
solution is here
amen
we are the one who's having the solution
no one solution is available
if you see a solution not coming forth
araya mahabutile le
tlo it's because we are not aligned with the
that is why Paul about specific
that the Paul is so specific
if tibele le lena bini
he say examine yourself
before deli na litumela
and see if you have faith
and le bona lo Jesu o bona mo lena
and see God
and o thoma o inibele la mwana modimo
when you start looking at yourself
o tlo khona o bona o khoko ba ha
you will see your evil ways
and what repent and o sokolo wa rapela modimo
and pray unto God
then modimo atla a o tshwara
and then God will forgive
because ke se modimo
that's what God
a rwa ngeli
so fighting against
gore re tshwantse re tlwele go ba le ignorance
that we should stop being ignorant
and re tlwele go ba le ignorance
if we stop being ignorant
Modimo
God
ramotsia mo le jing la hae
and take him at his ways
o tlotla a re tshwarela
come and forgive us
di vitsa rena
all of us
and then are libalela
and forgive us
and re rapela
that when we pray
what di thapelo tsa rena
we will hearken unto our prayers
then ara ba di thapelo tsa rena a go tsa na ya
go we will answer our prayers and heal our
bodies ba re ba le la pese singwe
I want the brother to read again here
then rekho motsi ba William Branham
so that we should know that William Branham
o rerile e Bible
has preached the Bible
message o rerile
the message that he read
as out tswaki le silo
not mixing it with anything
because it's not from Bible school
ka hore ha o tswe kwa sekola sa Bible
re ba le leng paragraph 420 o bro
paragraph ya ma kholo a mane le masume ma bedi
what that the spirit fight with
na moya o lwa ka eng
what does the Holy Spirit fight with
na moyo mokgethwa o lwa ka eng
sensation
maikutlo
feeling
maikwelo
ke se moyo wa modimo o lwa le sona
that's what the word of God
fights
we must come out of our feelings and sensations
ka re moyo wa modimo o lwa sona silo
because the word of God is fighting that
sari na botsi ya modimo le jing la
I was to take God at his way
and the rite ka mara kampa ya o se dumele
and get out of the camp of unbelief
be ba botsi ya modimo le jing la
and take God at his way
the whole armor of God
samo ka mo ka ya modimo
e moya tsona ke joy
one of them ke le thabo
so e mwana modimo
If a child of God is unable to be joyful in the presence of God, it means the devil has overcome him. Because heavenly God, when he explains,
one of the stress that we have that we can use, it is our joy.
Amen.
And the joy of the Lord is my strength. So
if we stay by God's will, even if we don't know what to say when we pray, when God is with in us, He will teach us on how to pray.
And hearing our joy.
When we need little
joy, are you holding about the magazine?
Joy is not found in magazines.
Joy, are you holding about the telling that the radio, the television?
It is not found in radio.
The joy of the Lord is my strength.
And
your joy, unseen things.
It's one of the things that are unseen.
Amen.
Go and read Galatians chapter 5, verse
22.
We'll
tell you this thing. The unseen ones.
And Elimata
brings the power of a Christian that can overcome by.
So when
the Son of God speaks these words,
saying,
we, the soldiers of
let
God,
let us close our mind.
Not even giving the devil a little moment
for
us to be able to overcome.
Let the man that was in Christ be
in us.
Stay with the weight.
Do that little in truth.
That is right.
Amen.
What you want to do?
Seven months later,
check the weight.
Challenge.
What is the weight? The Bible says, we just read it for the spirit. And God is the weight.
Right.
And take the helmet of salvation.
Fire
and a sword of the spirit.
Chosha.
The sword of the spirit. What is the sword? What is the sword of the spirit? The spirit that comes in through your mind and enter into you. And the sword of that spirit is the word of God.
So, for us to be overcomers, God has given us Himself so that we can be able to overcome by.
Colossians chapter 3.
Let's go to the book of
Colossians chapter 3.
Colossians chapter 3.
Revival from verse 30.
O tloate maneng ya le sumetharo
taba e ke yona ya nnete ba ba dimulenjela modimo.
This is a true way
that is why Paul are ange manje ba tuka muka ebe ma.
That's why Paul says let the words of every man be a lie but the word of God be a truth.
Revelation from verse 13 in
chapter 3
yeah, Colossians chapter 3
from verse
18:1-3.
Le fele le rwalana le le balalane
akere re ba Christ.
We are Christians.
Re rapela re fele re rwalana ka dithapelo.
When we pray we should carry one another.
Amen.
Ka kopulo ya nam
through a carnal thought
nka no rali sebo ke sivinyana.
I can say a gossip is just a little sin. It's not a small sin. It's a huge, big poison.
So risk us everyone.
For us not to gossip one another. Let us carry one another through prayers. Sometimes I should forget about my challenges and pray for my brethren. Pray for our elders. Pray for the office. Sometimes jump the office. And remember my precious brother here. And pray for him. I'm going to give you a certain matter here. I heard it being spoken by the brother. He said that the spirit came upon him. That he should pray. And pray for a brother or a sister in Christ.
And then
after praying for that person, we don't know why the word of God says we should pray one another for one another.
That the brother like goes.
Only to find that brother was going to face an accident. Through prayer,
in a light way.
That accident was there, but very light. By the time the spirit of God says pray,
one of our brethren,
How ignorant. He prayed, and then he lay on the accident.
Yeah.
Even though the certain place an accident,
Mara accident, they are now, but in the light way.
The reason was there, but like
one of our brethren, how ignorant.
When the Spirit of God said to him, pray, pray. Where we read here, he says, let us kill one another. Amen. Le fele le rwalane le lebalelalane ge bona le e a na go le tsaba le e mongwe boka kreste ge a le lebaletse le lena le dire ka mokgwa oo
ke o na le taba o na le taba o mongwe na le taba le o mongwe.
If one has got an issue with another,
kali na Christ are levalet.
As Christ has forgiven us,
ya mwa na Yesu,
I go to the brother,
rabula fasi,
sit down,
rabule,
speak,
alivale,
and forgives me.
Pilo ba chelati.
Life goes on.
Uthata bo na le bona.
Our problem,
ke o ignorance,
ke go se shetse.
Nka se nna.
I will never go there.
Mason.
One day, sure, Mason. I won't go. If I go
and a broom as soon as I don't travel,
and brother refused to
follow,
who's the man with the man with the case?
Liam,
I know I wronged him. I don't want to go. Who's getting the phone? That I know I wronged him, but I don't want to approach him. Brethren, may God help us.
This and evil curse.
That we should throw away pride.
Because of Barry,
they say,
way up.
It's way down.
We
have heard the verses that we read.
2 Chronicles chapter 7, verse 14.
We read from the book of 2 Chronicles. It speaks that we should humble ourselves. When you show humility, God cometh
and
raises you up. You know to be raised by God is good. Nobody will bring you down. You must know, brethren. If you see now what the politics are doing, we can come now and bring you, take it up.
We want you to be our president.
The
very same people
will come and take you down. But if you can be taken up by God, you will stay there forever.
So,
brethren, let me allow me to read this scripture before I close. Let's go to the book of
2 Chronicles. Maybe a few quotes and then we'll try
to read a few quotes and then we close.
2 Chronicles chapter 25.
Let's start from the first verse. Sechaba ka moka sa Juda sa tia usia mola asana le nwaga ene some le metso e selela sa modira khoshi le gatong la amatsia tatagwe yena o agile merako ya elathe go bane o be a busheditse motse wo go ba go Juda metleng ya ge khoshi amatsia a ithubaletse le botatagwe. Usia mola a thoma go busa o be a na le nywaga e lesome le metso e selelago a fetsa nywaga e masome a mahlano a metso e mebedi a le kgoši motseng wa Jerusalema. Leina la mmagwe e be e le Jekalia wa Jerusalema. O dirile tse di bego di kgatlha morena a etsa a matsia tatagwe e be e le motho e a nyakago morena metlheng ya ge Sakaria a mo ruta go boifa Modimo. Gomme metlheng yeo ge a sa nyaka morena, Modimo o be a mo atla.
Monna o ye a dira dilo.
This man, when he was doing things,
before I did deal,
because he was seeking God's face before he
did
them, God was blessing him. Amen. Give more verse. Oh, Thomas 6.
a tswa dira a lwa le ba filisita a phushula merako ya gathe le merako ya jabine le merako ya asidodo a aga metse e mengwe gona mo asidodo na ga ya ba filisita modimo o mothushitse go lwa le ba filisita le ba arabia le ba agile go guru bali le ba maneu
la utlwabe ba bala mo ba re modimo o mothusitse ulwa.
It says God has helped him to fight,
but a se arena
this battle is not ours.
Ke modimo,
it belongs to God.
And modimo na mothusa ka rene a sa monyaka.
God helped him because he was still seeking God's face.
Tsela mpeng bro
le ba amoni ba be ba le ba amoni ba be ba ntshetsa o sia dibego leina la gagwe la tuma le kwa egepeta gobane o ba atile maatla gagolo ke yena o sia a agilego merako ya dibo tsa Jerusalema mo kgorong ya sekhutlong le mo kgorong ya ngweding le ya mo dikhutlong tsa merako a ditiša le kwa lešokeng a aga dibo a epa didiba tse ntšhi tsa metsi gobane o be a na dikgomo tse ntšhi kwa melaleng le kwa mogoleng le balemi ba mašimo le bjabjadi bja merara dithabeng gobane o be a rata mašimo kudu.
Nka bona ke kgosi.
You see, kids, this Uzziah,
now we are Aira Dilo, as a Nagas for those
time. By the time God was doing things, looking for God's face first,
so Kenyaga recard.
I want us to cut a long story short,
verse 16,
and go to the 16th verse. And watch what happened after that. Mola atile matla, pelo ya hawe, kukumusha, ya muisha tinyeho. You see, when you start having pride, where do you go? You go to evil ways. So, for God to hearken unto our prayers, we must humble ourselves. When we start to boast or show pride, we are going the wrong way. Or we are going to destruction. Mola atile matla. Pelo ya gagwe e gogomosa ya moisha tshenyego a hlanogela morena modimo wa gagwe a ba a tsena ngwakong wa morena a re ke thuntšha diorelo a letareng
ke tsela e Satan a o disarmang ka yone.
This is the way that the devil disarms you.
O fa boikhukhumosi.
He gives you pride.
Wa tloela modimo.
Then you forget about God.
Mare le ka bala history ya hae ko morao.
If you can check his history back then.
Ntho e nngwe le nngwe ene a e dira.
Whatever he was doing.
Bible e re ne a prosper.
The Bible says o ba a atlega.
Because na nyaka sefatlhego sa modimo.
Because he was seeking God's face.
He a tlhokomela le pelo ya boikhukhumosi.
When he start to have this type of a heart.
Ya moisa tshenyego.
It led him to destruction.
Actually,
and he stopped seeking God's face.
So,
you can see he started for a while. Let us read and check how did he end up. Ba khala khoshi usia ba morera ba re go thuntshetsa morena di orelo ga go aswa ga go a swanela wena usia
ke sibitsa sa Satan se.
That is the devil's armor or weapon.
Ke ira di lotse di sa tshwanela mo di dira.
I do things that I'm not supposed to do.
Ba ba hulu ba tabang khala.
The elders comes and rebukes me,
ke ignore
then ka se shetse o ba ka hanetsa
le la pilo re bona go ira la di ka
go thuntshetsa morena diorelo ga go a swanela wena usia gobane beng ba modiro wo ke ba porisita barwa ba Aroni tswa mo sekgethweng wa sena mme tse bjalo di ka seke tsa go iša moo o tlo go retswa ke modimo usia a befelwa a swere moruswi wa diorelo ka seatla. You see, when you leave God, when they come and rebuke you,
instead you are wrong.
When the Lord accepts that you are wrong, you are angered. Let us see where that led him to. mme je bjalo di ka seke tsa go isha mo o tlo go retwa ke modimo o sia a be felwa a swere moruswi ka wa di orelo ka seatla a re a sa be feletse ba presita a tswa le phera a sa lebane le bona gona mo ngwa ko ngwa morena a eme a le tarang ya di orelo a sa ri ya mo presita e mogolo le ba presita bohle he ba mo lebeletse ba bona le phera le motjule phahleng ba mo ntshetsa ntle le yena ka noshi a gofa a tswa ka go bane morena a mo otlile gomme o sia yena goshi a dula e le wa le phera a ba gwa anala ananalo
amen
amen
mo ke nyaka re bone taba e
I want us to see this matter
re ibali le ko 1 John chapter 1 ila
that we read from the book of 1 John chapter 1
23 pulele DB
that we should confess our sins
and then re bala ko 2 Chronicles ke bulela ka o ikopometsa
2 Chronicles speaks of humility
and then re tle mo spatsi o sa modimo
and come to God's face
khoshi uzi
the king Uzziah
na ko a sa nyaka spatsi o sa modimo
when he was seeking God's face
a ira dilo
whatever he did
ne a atlega
he was prospering because ne a nyaka spatsi o sa modimo because he was seeking God's face
bya no ka bona tselo pili ya hai
after noticing his progress
a bona rawa
he said
na ke tshwara dilo di a tlhaka
when I touch things they do
bo pili ya tle ya tsena ke pride
then pride entered him
atwela modimo
he forgot about God
anya go dira dilo tsena sa tshwanela o di dira
he wanted to do things that were meant for him to be done
ibulela specific
you see the bible is very specific
yiro ofisa di orela o tshwanetse ba priest
it says the burning of incense is up to
and
the priest
and yena le a ile khoshi a simu priest
being a king is not a priest
no yena anya go tsiya mmereko wa go ba priest
he wanted to take the priest duties
aba priest ka le ba ka la re ba re le lindzi la modimo
the priest because they are carrying God's will
ba na le matla ya o khala sibi
they have the power to rebuke sin
e ba tla ba tlo mo khala
when they came to rebuke him
ibile ira a bifelo
the bible says he was angered
sibi sela sa re mo
that sin came upon his head
aba a top of ala le lephele
he died being affected by leprosy
aba le lephele le la ke sona sibi
you see that leprosy
so ka thoma go tsi mwana modimo
please brother sister don't start right
and then wa feel letsa bubi
and complete wrong or finish it
all with sibing
yes we are born in sin
are sekoloeng
let us repent
and then retle mo modimo
and come to God
re khonotse le re kwa
so that when we die
re khwele moreneng
we should die
with God re ska tshwana le kopo mongwe
let us not be like a certain old woman
le wa bona wa lwala
after realizing that she was
arbana
was about to die
ko ritse wa le tlhologo a kwa ngakwela moreneng
and said to my the children they told me that blessed is the one who died in the presence of God.
Kubela le nwale lengkise ko morena simangmang.
Please take me to a certain lord.
Mo re bulela ka o khwela moreneng modimo wa rena.
Here we talk of dying to God our lord.
Yo wena confess le dipi ka moka.
The one whom thou have confessed as sin unto.
O tla o libalela
that he forgive you
and wa khwela moye.
And will die before him
so what he was
the king was here
u hanle u solwa
he did not accept to be rebuked
and taba e isa dirala le hona bya no
even today this thing is happening
young people
ba swa
e batswadi ba le khala go hai
when the parents are rebuking you at home
la ra ba skere
you answer
la ra wa mama
you will say mami
papa
daddy
o le rena le fitile mo mustapha
you also passed through this
yo lo ba fitile mona
if they passed by there
and when na le mutsa ba ba fitile mona
and you got the evidence that they passed by there
mara ba o khala
when they rebuke you
abanya go go bone tse bona ba di bona
they don't want you to go
kana what they want
bana le lona
amen
ka le rato le bana le
lona oh by the love that they have
dumela o khaliwa
accept to be rebuked office bar or no office bar ya mo service
moholo wa mo puthegong wa ese moholo puthegong
e ba bona re ke dirile phoso
if they realize that I've done wrong
and then bank khala
and they rebuke me forget about my office bar ya ke le bala ka gore ke ka ba ntoro
ke dumela go khaliwa
and let me again accept to be rebuked
ke tsene mo lining ya le tsela mo
tell me align with the word of God
because how hana go khaliwa
because if I refuse to be rebuked
this sign ya re ke na le the mark of the beast
it's a sign that I've got
sign of the
mark of the beast.
And I will die and go to the grave with that. The word of God shows us that let us empty ourselves to God.
Mark chapter 12.
Let's start there by the 30th verse. Morena modimo wa gago o morate ka pelo ya gago ka moka le ka moya wa gago ka moka le ka saloganyo ya gago ka moka le ka matla a gago ka moka ke ona molao o mogolo
la bona bana ba modimo.
You see, brethren,
modimo a ona mo re ka gang ntle khetswa.
There is no way we can build a holy place.
Modimo a dula mo yona.
God come and dwell.
Modimo o se ka khetse ntle khetswa.
God has built himself a holy place.
Ke nna le wena le wena.
That is you and me.
And modimo o feletse a dutse mo ntlong ya dikamora tse tharo.
God is complete when he dwells in a room of three rooms.
So in a house of three souls.
So if you love God, you must love him with all of your heart, with all of your spirit, and with all of your strength. You see, this man called Samson, he was blessed by God. But he did something that I don't want you and me to do.
Samson has surrendered matla hai kamuka hai hai umudim.
Samson has surrendered all his power, strength unto God.
But as he surrendered pilu umudim.
But did not surrender the heart to God.
So we must surrender our heart to God. Because mudimu arna ushumela body pilu.
Because God operates from our heart.
So se sinyake hambanwa mudimu.
What is required, brethren? If we know that we love God, sincerely,
all our three offices, then
we should love him through all our three offices that
body, spirit, and soul.
Let us give all unto God.
Obedience is better than sacrifice.
Is when we can give our all unto God.
Body, spirit, and soul.
Let us not be like Samson. He surrendered his strength, all his strength to God.
But as he
But failed to surrender his heart. Our God is the God of hearts. If we can open our hearts unto God, and he comes and dwell among us, all things before God they are possible. I was just saying, brethren, today,
this opportunity,
with this opportunity, we should complete the issue of prayer. We don't just pray,
we must confess our sin,
and
repent.
God
will
forgive us. As we are getting like this, we do do wrong unto one another. I must go to my brother and ask forgiveness. When we read the word of God, in the book of Luke 15, the Bible says there was a man who had two kids. One came to him and said, give me what is belonging to me. I want to go. He felt that he was old. That he was independent.
Independent.
It's the way that we normally use and say, want to be independent. I believe a Christian should not be independent. A Christian must be led by someone. And that person is the Holy Ghost. When the dead gave whatever to the son, the Bible says he went away. Went to a strange nation. Then he used that richness until he ate with the pigs.
We are not saying that this brother.
But what I love about this brother, one of the days, he came back to his senses.
And then Aba Ananarkana
and remember that back at home,
Limalata,
even
even the workers, they eat and they throw away. Let me tomorrow wake up and go back to my father. He planned it well. And he said, when I arrive with my father, I will say, Father, forgive me. I don't even qualify to be called your son.
And
indeed, he spoke it straight. And he said, Father, I did wrong
to
you. Not only you. You are in the heavens. I don't qualify to be your son. What did the son the father do?
Accepted the wrong.
Because the child has accepted the wrong. Forgive him. The Bible says even
imagine,
I will give him a holy kiss. Then there was a feast.
So
even our God,
that's why it's woman need.
Our real father. Amen.
Or
it's waiting for us.
Are recognizing our wrongs.
So that we recognize our wrongs.
And then
and go back to him. And say, Father, we've wronged you. Forgive us. God is
going
to forgive us. He won't forgive us automatically.
We must confess our sin.
So
that I confess.
The issue of confession and prayer and forgive and forget is very important. It is one of the things that can help us to be overcomers. If we continue to
continue,
when Jesus was taken to the cross, he went with two sinners. One was
on
the left, the other on the right. One of the sinners. Start mocking Jesus.
And it's Bible.
You must know that Bible says, you can mock me, but do not mock the Holy Spirit. Because the Holy
Spirit.
You say this one said, because you are a son of God, save yourself and us as well. He was mocking Jesus Christ. The other one.
Recognizes
that the punishment that we are getting is defeating us because we are sinners. But if it's this one, it's not worth it.
My brother,
say your brother, because we are together. How do you speak to God? Don't you know that this befits us? This one does not befit him.
Aba a confess or yena kumu
yetadi. He confessed that he was a sinner.
Aba a utiwe uri.
Just because he said to him,
leave home
today.
Probably we're in paradise.
I'll be with you in paradise.
And I will be left here.
It was a sinner.
Mola Maria ayi atsurua. Jesus Christ kwa kutenga.
When his blood was spilled by the cross.
Aba abulela manji.
And he spoke the words.
Arinta te.
He said, Father,
Bacharel,
forgive them.
Abati misi basidi.
Because they don't know what they're doing.
Bacharelo vanwa mudim.
Forgiveness.
Ife iwe.
Is there?
Ati maruli eri rapela.
We know that when we pray.
Iri eri rapela.
That was his only prayer. We must make sure that we forgive each other's sins. We only forgive each other's sins when I dealt away with pride.
My brother.
And go to the brother.
Brother.
I did wrong to you.
1, 2, 3.
Say the same. When we pray, our matter will go. Our prayer will go to God. If you see that brother are not teaching God, it's because you don't come the right way. God gave us
a
message in our time.
William Branham,
one nation Branham.
I read a message
and even preached the message.
What respect?
What from
God demanded respect. I must respect.
So I must respect
my deacon.
But
I must respect my pastor. Regardless of what age.
If
you don't respect that person, respect that office.
God gave them unto us. What is needed?
We must humble ourselves.
Amen.
And
see God's face.
And then Mudimu
and God.
Aliodimu
being in heaven.
Utota
will come.
Atewa
come down.
Then I will tap on the tree.
Hear our prayers.
See, this is close to Mudimu.
What is it that brings it down God?
My child, Ari.
Now
it's our
attitude
towards God.
So Ari, then Mudimu can go to let us love God at all times.
Emoya di bisa then Mudimu arifilenton.
One of the weapons that God has given to us.
Rekasi buleris.
We won't speak much on it.
Hey, Urata, bro.
If I love you, brother,
I will respect you.
Yeah.
And as long as we respect us,
as long as I respect you, you see, brother,
I don't know those watches.
Yeah.
He said, when the watch gives us the right time,
it's
because those pointers, they work together. All of us here, we must be in harmony.
And the
we must not come to a point where we undermine each other.
Let us love one another. Respect one another. And then
God will come and
bless you richly.
Shall fall.
ya modimo ye me ka maoto
kreste scripture ke tsalo se ama tema wena ba no ba tla ka bona ke la fa ile ke ta ama tle bona ke tsong ka tsa tsoma tema ro se le sa ke tsona sore ta yo sina fa se ama tema ka tema wena e bala pele ke di pele ke mo no bona ba tla ka go tsa sala ta go ba ke bisha go tsa ama tema ka rona se ya ba ye na go sala ta go ke bisha go tsa ama tema ke le ka se ka go se ka go tsa ta ba tla ona ke tsong ka tsa se ke tsona ba sa ra go sa ke go tsa na ke ba go tsa ta ke go le ke